Alright, in this session we are going to learn about JSON. So what it means, JSON is a JavaScript object notation. A common use of JSON is to read data from a web server and display the data in a web page. Means commonly what it does, it read the data from our web server and display the data in our web page, which is user interface, from where we can see our output. So this is lightweight data interchange format. So it is easy to read and write and often used with AJAX. Mostly we use JSON with AJAX call. So used with most modern languages. Now we will look about the data types in JSON. So these are the data types which it supports. First of all, this is number, means support integer and float. Second one is string. Then boolean, array, object and null. So we can use these type of data types in JSON. So there are some rules for JSON, like it use key value pairs. Means if we want to define a JSON format, we have to compulsory write our data within a key value format, and data is separated by comma. Means if we are passing two value like name and another property like whatever subject, so we have to compulsory separate them with the comma. So our next value will be like this, so we will define over here. So use double quote around key and value, like we have to write our key value within double quote. Must use the specified data types, means the data types which JSON support must used. And file type is all know that .json, and its MIME type is application/json, and curly braces hold objects. Means there are two values in JSON, like one is array, another one is object. So if we are using object, so we have to write our object into curly braces. And if data is in square brackets, then we can know that this is the array. So let's have a look, like our object, how our object will look like this. If we are using an object, then we will define like this, means within a curly braces we will define our data within key value format. And if we are passing a JSON array, then we will use the square brackets. So this is our array. There are some most useful array functions like stringify and parse. So here this is the most important line, like converting a string to a native object is called parsing. Means if we want to convert our string into an object, then we use the parse method. And converting a native object to a string, we transmitted across the network, is called the stringification. Means if we want to convert our object into a string, then we use the json.stringify. So these are the function like json.stringify. It convert a JavaScript object into a string. So this is our example, like where obj equal to this. And if we want to, so let's have a look with the example. Here I have my code editor and have one HTML file. So I will create a script tag over here, and suppose this is our object. Like how we can identify that this is object with the curly braces. So this is our object. Now we are taking another variable and we are stringify this object. Then we will see that how our output will look like. So we will define this into console log my JSON. And I have already explained about the console's object in my previous video, which link I will provide in my description box. When you will run this application, then you will find the within the console the object like name C. It will stringify our objects. Here double quote is not available, but when we will do stringification, then it will convert it into a string. So this is our stringification, and it will convert according to the type, means C. This is the number type, so it will not define into double quote. So we can easily get that this is the number or float or any type. So this is the use of stringify, JSON dot stringify. And our another method is, suppose this is an array, so I will get this example in my Visual Studio Code. See, so this is my example. Here I have one p tag, parameter tag, and one object variable I and x, and my object contains name, age and cars. Now I want to see the cars, so cars value. So how you can directly get this value? For that you have to repeat into the loop. So we will define a for loop, I in our object, then the element, particular key. So we want the key car values, so we will repeat into loop. So here x equal to obj.car, then we will set into the paragraph, then see what will happen. When we will run our application, refresh, then you will get that these values has been set into our paragraph tag. So there are so many ways in which we can use the JSON in different ways, so which is very helpful in our programming and very easy to use. So this is our example. So this is the brief intro about the JSON. I will explain more details in my next video. So thanks for watching, guys.